Hi friends. Well, we've gone from snow in Sonoida to shorts and sandals in Yuma, Arizona. We're at the Riverfront RV Park. Please enjoy my stories or whatever else might be on my mind today. It was a good move, weather-wise. We have spent a week or two here every year because we have friends that are three blocks from here. They live in a house, but they used to live down where we live in Mexico. And we visit them every year for a few days. So this is kind of like one of our coming home places, if that's the way we feel when we get here. But let me show you some of the stuff around here that I find it interesting to look at. Hooked up, probably since last year. It's the first time I've been hooked up since I was back here in this park. I don't hook up my sewer. I hook up to dump when I arrive, and I hook up to dump before I leave. Otherwise, my tanks are quite sufficient. This is kind of a maintenance room here. I think they just got storage stuff in there, that building, speaking of maintenance. And next door is the laundry room. Guy over here in the telephone booth. I've stood here and waited to use the phone for 4 years, and the guy never gets done. Old gas pumps. Oh, look at this rope. You know, I have the same kind of rope on my boat. And then I had about 25 feet of it that I still own. I have it in my van in Mexico, and I use it as a tow rope if I need it. Watering can. Old vise. Oh, look at this. I worked on a ranch when I was a kid, and I bought one of these for $5, which was a day's wages. It's a drill press. I had it for about, I don't know, 40 years. When I sold everything and moved to Mexico, I sold it at my garage sale for, I think, $55. Laundry room. This is a Pekino Monday, Wednesday, bingo on Thursday, and music jam Saturday at 1 o'clock. That's what's going on in there now. I don't want to go in there because they're playing music. Mirador. I don't know if they call them miradors here in Yuma. That's what we call them at home in Mexico. Old telephone cable reel table. We used to have those in the backyard in Mission, South Dakota when I was growing up. There's somebody throwing a horseshoe. Fountain. Kind of reminds you of Mexico. Windmill. Old boards have been here. They feel pretty solid, but you never know. What else we got here? Oh, some kind of engine. Might have been a steam engine. No, I don't want to make a fool of myself. This is an industrial size drill press. And another old kind of engine. I don't know. Call them a one-longer or a one-banger or, I don't know. Somebody that knows will put it in the comments. There's a baby buggy. Sans seat. También sans niño. Horse collar. My mother told me when she was a baby they used to throw that down on the ground and it was her crib. Old tree, old saddle, old boot, old cowboy, tack. Oh, look at this motor. Outboard motor. Ooh, look at this stove. Martin and King. Cook stove. Oh, it's actually hooked up to use. Look at that. Goes chimney way up there. Good draw. No damper. That thing's gonna cook. Big tree. Wow. Yeah, big group of people in there for the music jam session Saturday afternoon. I think I need a windmill on the ranch. We got plenty of wind. What do we got here? Pioneer, Texas. Ford. Horseless carriage, Grand Canyon State, number 847. Is there a year? 51. I can't read it. I thought it was going to be older. The pickup's older. Riverfront RV Park. Wouldn't it be fun to restore that? So, I don't know, somebody's gonna correct me again, cause who knows about this stuff. Model A? No, I think it's newer than that. I'm gonna guess 1932. I got a story about that windshield. You remind me to tell it to you someday. It's too long a story for this walking around stuff. Ooh, there's another car. Oh, wait. It's a pickup. Hi there. Good music jam? Yeah, I'm going to guess 1932 again. Somebody who knows will correct me. O.S. Scott. What does that say? Can't read it. Phone number. 3623. Oh, maybe he was a plumber. Probably the plumbing is lots newer than the truck. What do we got over here? Besides a lot of firewood. Railroad ties. A boiler. Big old boiler. Looks like it's boiled its last boil. She owns all this property and a whole bunch of property over there on the other side of that park too, where she's got a warehouse full of antique cars that she's got covered up and preserved. There's a pavilion down there. I'm gonna walk down there and I'll turn the camera back on when I get there. What a grand old, I believe, weeping willow tree, maybe. Some kind of willow tree. And look at this. What the heck is that? Two-cylinder Baker Ice Machine Company. Big compressor thing to make ice back in the day. Wow. What a piece of machinery. Replaced after 100 years by that. Another one of those telephone cable reel tables. Nice and cool under here. Oh, look at this wheel. I'll bet you that came off of the ice maker machine over there. Yeah. And down here, we have part of the Colorado River. I'm not really sure. It might be all of the Colorado River. In case you didn't know, 80% of the leafy green vegetables eaten in the United States are grown here in the Yuma Valley. All made possible by the Colorado River water. Arizonans call these the tules. What a huge piece of property. Well, I redid the camera mount on my electric tricycle. And we're gonna go for a ride in the nice park in Yuma along the river. Might be a little bouncy, but pretty good stabilization on that Acaso Brave 7 camera. Well, I did go for a ride on the bicycle with the new camera mount, and it turned out to be a much more stabilized and better video than the old camera mount. But it got to be kind of long because it's my favorite bicycle ride in Arizona. Along the Colorado River in Yuma, it's just beautiful. And it got to be longer than I anticipated because I just couldn't stop going. Anyway, we'll save that for the next video. Thanks for watching today. And as a very good friend of mine says, where are we going to end this video? Right here. Hey, if you like me, give me one of those thumbs up. And please subscribe and hit that little bell so you know when I post next. Please share me with your friends on social media. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed what was on my mind today.